I welcome Director of Karnataka Chairperson, Mrs. Shekhudul Iyer. Please come to the dais. No, no, please. Okay, here is who's.
Sir, I don't know.
Now, in your absence, your job of Chairperson was being taken away. And that can be a problem in the game.
Arvind Rathod, the second one you won't like, that's okay. Because as it's your best studio, I've been asking you. I have just a couple of things to say, sir. One is, every state has come out with its own set of rules. Many are inconsistent with the act. Even in Karnataka, it's been watered down in terms of online products. Now, in a sense, the act is very clear that only those who have obtained this completion certificate are excluded from the provisions of the act. Here, they have brought in an exception to say those who have applied for also are outside the purview. Those who have sold 60% white sale meats are outside the purview. Those who have relinquished their parks and open spaces are outside the purview, which is not a part of the scheme of the act. The fundamental question is again the same thing, sir. Whether a rule can actually be contrary to the provisions of an act. And yes, because the general principle is the rule should be an enabling provision to the act, it cannot be contrary. So that is what we have done in Karnataka, whereas in Tamil Nadu, they have clearly said the undivided share of land will still be sold to the authority, which is again the scheme of the act. So what I was just like, we had the right to make a state amendment for any act, like we did in the case of the Infrastructure Act. Whether it be more advisable to an amendment to the Karnataka Rera Amendment Act to bring these things in tune, otherwise there will be a conflict as far as the rules of the act are concerned. One. Secondly, I had an opportunity to go through your agreement draft, which was uploaded to the website yesterday, sir. There's just one or two things I want to point out. One is, I think obviously that is just by oversight. They have still used the word VAT and service tax. That should be replaced by GST. And the most other thing is slightly, again, I was pointing to the version of the Act. We have a section under clause 10 on conveyance. The draft says the carpet area of the apartment along with proportionate undivided share of the common area can be sold to the allottee. Well, the act is very clear that proportionate undivided share can only be sold to the association of allottees and not to the allottee. So there seems to be a dichotomy between the act and the agreement per se. The third thing I noticed in the agreement, sir, we have been asked to clearly specify what is the cost of my carpet area, what is the cost of my land, what is the cost of my car parking. Covered parking has also been bought in, which actually is a common area under the parent act. Only a garage is not a common area. Now, you have asked me to so on and so forth, split up to various things. Question is, my undivided share of land cannot be sold to the allottee. Whether it is right to specify what the consideration paid for that. When the car parking, car parking cannot be sold to the allottee. Whether it's right to say, please specify the price of the covered car parking. When the internal balcony in your apartment or your terrace apartment cannot be sold, only exclusive right to use and enjoy more as a licensee is conferred on you. Whether it can ask to be defined on the sale price related to that. Because the agreements ask us to define and split the sale price and consideration accordingly, which very contrary to the provisions of the Act.
Many questions, so leave anything to please tell me. The first one is, what is being construed here as a conflict in our opinion is not a conflict. It's explanatory in nature. And the proof of pudding is in its meaning. We are not adding legal challenge in law. We are so sure about the conflict. Let's discuss it. And then, a court table on it in the final sense. So that is the view. Here it examined all these points. It is a responsibility of the state government also to ensure that the laws are implemented. And if it is done by way of explanation, it will be perfectly fine with it. And we think that none of the sections, I repeat, none of the sections. despite strong words like dichotomy or conflict being used, it's not so. They're very clear on that. And it's been a much reasoned, much argued. So that is that it stands, as far as the state is concerned, it stands. Then the second question is about the agreement of sale, etc. It has been put on the web. Because you have to add a question here, we cannot answer. Then there is no agreement of sale, what do we do, and so on and so forth. Was there? This is actually our original draft. Okay? Pre-GST draft. It's very good. Don't change it much. If you have any suggestions, you please go into it. To us. We have to be interact with a wide spectrum. Okay? Narenko and its people here are a small component of the total wide spectrum which would be impacted by this agreement of sale. So, there will be many sections which will be added and deleted. Also, this agreement of sale, I'm telling you right up front, does not take into account many of the complexities which are there, especially in the commercial realization. So, there will be some changes to this, but because we have flooded with inquiries, there is no agreement of sale, there will be people saying, no, you have done a conflict with that, and you have not defined agreement of sale. Well, the state law will not that, will take our time. No yes rate of project gets completed in 3 months, as far as we know. So, this agreement of sale was a draft. So, the questions on that.
We are there to consolidate it and we want to submit to start it.